guys, it's your boy, and welcome to back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool Cremo, where last time off, I picked up wins in the Premier League over Arsenal and Middlesbrough. In this episode, I've gone knockout stage game against Juventus in the Champions Cup. Champions Cup, we know what it is. We know it's the Champions League, EA, whatever you want to call it. We know what it is. I mean, if you're worried about licensing and copyright and that bullshit, if you're gonna change the name, then have a different trophy, the fucking Champions League trophy, and they just have a different name. They say, "Oh, yeah, that's totally different. That's not the same thing at all." And then for the Europa League, they have the same thing as well. Oh, for God's sake! Kingsley Coman, you slippery little shit. Cavalera or Lennon from the Big Bang Theory, seriously. Oh, and I went the right way as well. Fuck you, Dybala. Shit. That's not the best start. Let's rectify that. Oh, the post!
His teammates will thank him for that.
Marquisio. Gonzalo Higuain.
Oh boy.
Khedira. Well, that's straightforward.
This is going to be a... Ah! Ragnar Klavan, you fucking asshole! What are you doing? We're already 1-0 now through bullshit. We don't need to be 2-0 now through bullshit.
There's been a menace to it.
Moya. Oh, Kingsley Coman was an inch away from fucking conceding a penalty, which would have been karma. Alexander-Arnold! Oh, that is bullshit. I'll take it. Bullshit for bullshit. We're evil. We're evil? We're even. We're a bit of a prick. Okay, but I wouldn't say evil. That might go down as an own goal for Giorgio Chiellini. I think it is. Yep. The man who was the recipient of the third Luis Suarez bite. Oh no, it's given it to Alexander-Arnold. Must have been going in anyway. Regardless of the
both sides have scored here now.
Contribution from Chiellini.
Well, they're in a good position here. The through pass. In the end, it's...
I was going to say, do not concede straight away. That would be some level of bullshit. Sheojo. From against Marquinhos. Just past him. And goes fuck off. Off nowhere with the ball. Brilliant.
Trying to stretch the opposition using the wider areas.
I'll take that throw.
Moving forward with
some danger to the opposition now they're here. LeBlanc.
Good place to win the ball here.
Alexander-Arnold!
danger momentarily, but it is a corner following that good tackle.
What the fuck is attached to Coleman's head? Anyone else knows that? What the fuck is that? Also, I'm actually surprised to see Coleman is back at Juventus. That's definitely not going to happen in real life. All indications are that he will be a Bayern Munich player. I think he actually... No, it's at the end of this season that Bayern Munich have the option to buy him for like 5 million or some shit like that. Crazy. Those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, I believe the deal for Kingsley Coman between Bayern Munich and Juventus is he's on a 2-season long loan, so last season and this season.
Attacking well here. To put them in front. It's a chance well taken.
At the end of the second season, Bayern Munich have the option to make the move permanent for like less than, I don't even think it's anywhere near 10 million. So I'm like, okay. If that's true, you're thinking, okay, well, at the start, Kingsley Coman was, a young kid with rumored to have high potential. We've seen that high potential, and seen that there's a lot of potential, and freaking Juventus are frantically trying to figure out how the hell they can, get this deal null and void, but they freaking backed themselves into a corner. There is no way Bayern Munich won't keep Kingsley Coman. Especially if they're getting him cheap. I mean, if I was Bayern Munich manager, I would be freaking loving life. Because even if eventually in Kingsley Coman, imagine they make Kingsley Coman into the next big thing. And every team from Barcelona to Real Madrid to the Man Cities, the Chelseas, everyone will want him. And you can either keep him if you can, or you can count the profit. Especially if they're getting him cheap.
Ready to go for the second half of this Champions Cup match for a place in the quarterfinal.
It's fucking mental. It is absolutely mental.
Looked very good indeed, but the move is broken down. Claudio Marchisio. Coman. Free kick.
So, chances are we'll never see E. Coman in a Juventus shirt again. Unless, somewhere down the line, he goes back to Juventus. But I don't think he'll be rejoining Juventus after this loan spell. I think 100% Bayern Munich will make it permanent. And come next game, Kingsley Coman will be a permanent feature at Bayern Munich. Until someone signs him away in Kremer, of course. Because everyone fucking signs everyone in fucking.
Mario Marchisio getting into attacking positions here, Juventus. Saw it coming, cut it out, good work. He might be through.
Go on, David. Yeah, 4-1. Get in. Right on the hour mark as well. Beautiful.
There. What a counter attack.
Ideally, I'd like to get 2 more goals because of the Juventus goal. Well, it's not an away goal, so it's not as annoying as it would be if it were an away goal. the fact that they have one goal is still, you know, driving my patience. And they got your bullshit. It makes it a bit worse. Penalty! 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 Oh, absolutely fuck off. I clip your man and at the start of the game and you give a penalty. Foxy. He took my player out. Freaking slid in behind him. And you give nothing. You know, you look at it twice. You're just like, oh, no, that's not a penalty. He, fuck off, you whore. Bullshit. What a load of bullshit. What is that? So, I don't get a penalty. A clear-cut penalty. Considering the one that was given against me. And then they fucking smash one in. And that was a dude. That dude is a defensive midfielder, I think. If I have the right player. So what the fuck is going on? This game is like, nah, you're playing the second game. There's just no going around it. Wait, Mustafi? Have you read this going on all attack? This could be a great way to recover a bit from the bullshit they have. No, this looks like Mustafi traveled up the field. Bonucci and Chiellini were still back there.
Done well to get it wide, not done so well
with the bit of the beauty that Juventus can afford with their three key center backs. I'm never going to get to 7 goals even if they are on all attack. That fucking bullshit, man. Moya. Nope, of course not.
And that will be Liverpool's throw-in.
I expected him to collect the ball. That's why I pulled back on the thing. So when he got the ball, he would turn. I anticipated it. And he fucking stopped. He fucking stopped and it looked like I was going for the throw, which I wasn't. Oh my god, the bullshit in this game. Oh my god, fuck off, Buffon. Fuck off. Fuck off. And you're retiring at the end of this season as well. Well, for those of you wondering how the hell I know that, is because I'm looking for region jobs.
Well, good through ball. Terrific tackle. Leonardo Bonucci. And that's a win confirmed.
Here's a full time whistle. I have no words. I have no words for what the fuck just happened. Chelsea lost to PSV. Unfortunately, that doesn't count in the Premier League.
Liverpool 4. PSV.
Can you come over to the Premier League there for PSV and be him in that? Because that'd be great. I don't have a Premier League game in this episode. Next game is a FA Cup game against Crystal Palace. Here you can see the other fifth round games. Whoa! Forgot to do something, I think. Yep. Ooh, that would have been bad. No, that lineup is fine by me. I just wanted to change Alexander-Arnold for Ojo. Did I see that right? Please tell me I was imagining the name I just saw. Did that say David Webb? Oh my god, there's another one. Oh my god, there's another Webb? There's another Webb? We finally get rid of the fucking asshole that is Howard Webb, and there's a fucking another one! Brilliant! So, is he real? Is that real, or is that a made-up referee in-game? Please tell me that's a made-up referee. If he is a real referee, please tell me he's a league... He's a freaking lower division referee. He'll never ref in the Premier League. Oh my god. Another Webb. Fantastic. So, oh... If he is real, we can look forward to that again. Oh my god, the amount of shit we had to put from Howard Webb. As bad as he was as a referee, now we have to hear him every fucking time. I have to hear him every time in Liverpool or on fucking ESPN. Or fucking BT Sports, or whatever the fuck it's called. Getting my fucking chat. Both mixed up. And whenever they're on BT Sports, oh, we have Howard Webb with us. Why? To get his fucking biased opinion against Liverpool? Fucking, if you're looking for someone to give their biased opinion, give Gary Neville a ring. Or fucking any Man United player. Giggs. He's not doing anything. Because he got snubbed for the Swansea job again. Or he just didn't take it. Whichever.
Held off the defender with good touches here. Attacking now. And it's a shot now! Really snatched at the shot. And it's gone well wide.
Unfucking believable.
Here's Emery Moore. Well, they're in a good position here.
Who knows? Maybe he'll be okay. Maybe he won't. This guy won't be a whore. Maybe he'll be one of the good ones. It's a very rare occurrence.
Johan Kabay. Benteke.
It's to find a non-whore referee, but We'll see. When it comes to how he makes his decisions. Will he give a fair? Will he referee this game fair? Or will he go one way or another?
Pizarro.
Now don't get me wrong. I don't want a referee in my favor. I want the referee to call the match down the fucking middle like referees are supposed to. They're not supposed to favor one team, but of course, all the referees in fucking England are corrupt. And, you know, and this was proven to be true because one of them came out and said that, yeah, we've taken a few bribes. Thieves. And I'm like, are you fucking kidding me? You actually admitted that. How did they not all get fired? I was like, what? We've known this for years, and for some reason, a lot of people were shocked. A lot of people were shocked when that news came out. I was like, do you watch any Liverpool game? Because you obviously don't, because if you did, You see the amount of bullshit we have to put up with from the officials. And even though that's been revealed, that they do take a few thousand there, or nice new car, nice new house, nice new slut to fuck after the game, during the game. Fucking hell, I'm surprised more referees don't come out fucking their bitch halfway on the fucking pitch. That's how fucking corrupt these assholes are. Or sorry, whores.
Pressure on the player, that's why it's come out.
Calling them an assholes is a fucking insult to assholes everywhere.
Will be Liverpool's throw-in. Baba, there's some potential in this move, and in goes the cross. Shot on. Well, he won't be watching the playback of this.
Steve, what the fuck was that? What the actual fuck was that? What was that? Freaking boom!
Referee by the fourth official, that's the decision regarding added time. Andros Townsend.
Ah, oh, for God's sake.
They're on the move now. So it's one.
Half time. You can see your score lines. Grooch is a. Header is the only goal in this game at the moment. Emery Moore might change that. He's running down on goal. One on one with Mendenna! What a save! Or did that hit the post? It looked like a save to me, so that's why I'm crossing this. Now the fucking commentators are probably saying, oh, that hit the fucking post. Keep in mind, I can't hear them. Because I hear enough of Smith and Tyler when they're fucking commentating together on Sky Sports. Thank you very much.
I don't think there's too much between the two sides.
I don't know why people want to listen to the commentary and when they're watching a game. I will always mute the game because the whole point is to watch the game. You're not supposed to, you know, this is not like it's a fucking live reading of fucking Stephen King or some shit like that. No, this is a football match. You know, you watch for your eyes see. Your ears aren't part of the experience. If you're listening, you're not paying attention. If you're trying to listen to the fucking commentators and whatever bullshit they're spouting.
Brilliant football from this team.
I will especially, immediately, if I hear Michael Owen, because I will fucking kill that dumbass. If I, it is bad enough that I have to see his fucking dumb face, his dumb traitorous face, but the fact that I have to listen to his annoying voice, he's,
good idea to try and use the,
I mean, it's just so annoying. You never notice someone's, you know. Now that when I actually have to listen to him is whenever I have to watch a game that he's on with someone. He goes, my dad likes to listen to commentary for whatever reason. They don't ever say anything of importance. They don't say anything that affects the game. They don't have any impact on the game. You know. The only thing commentary is good for is when they, you know, lose their shit over good goals. You know, like the Aguero moment from a few seasons ago. Oh, the reactions to some of Stevie G's great goals. That's the only time you listen to the commentary. But that's what freaking in the match of the day is for.
Well, the clock's showing 9 minutes left to play.
You watch match of the day, and then you can hear what the commentator said when the goal went in. Otherwise, if you're more focused on the commentator, then you neglect the goal. And, well, Aguero's goal was good. It was more... Martin Tyler more or lost his shit and climaxed all over the fucking booth because of the occasion. Let's be honest. And Martin Tyler probably admit that because, you know, the goal was okay. It wasn't a fucking 50-yard screamer. It wasn't a bicycle kick. It wasn't a scorpion kick. Like Olivier Giroud and Mkhitaryan style. It was an okay goal. It was a goal, you know, you see him scored a million fucking times. Just a flat pass through. Nice finish. I'll give Aguero that. Nothing taken away from the importance of the goal. The goal was super important, but overall, it wasn't a good goal. It was an important goal, but it wasn't like the best finish ever, you know. It will go down in history. The goal will 100% go down in history, but not because, you know, it was a fucking awesome goal. Oh, and, you know, oh. Wait, you will tell your kids, you remember where you were when Aguero scored that goal. And when your kids look at you and say, hey, why do you remember that goal? Well, what was so good about it? You'll say, the importance and the commentary he combined together made the goal so historic. There wasn't anything too special about the goal, you know, it was a standard goal. And I'm not trying to take anything away from Sergio Aguero. He's a fantastic player. Every time he performs his ass off for Manchester City, he is a fantastic player. I'm not trying to take anything away from the goal he scored. It just, you know, it wasn't a bicycle kick. It wasn't a scorpion kick. It wasn't a scissors kick. It wasn't any of those kind of special goals. And you're like, oh my god, that goal was so amazing. It wasn't a long ranger. It wasn't, you know, a good header. It was just a good finish. It was a good finish, but, you know, it wasn't a special finish in that it wasn't, you know, it wasn't a memorable goal. For the finish, it was more about the importance of the goal. I don't know why I'm arguing this. I don't know who I'm arguing with. Really? Did I see that right? Are you fucking kidding me? Again. Fucking believable. This is unfucking believable. Look at that. Hull in the EFL Cup. That's the final. 2 days later, I play Chelsea. 2 days later, I play Chelsea. Chelsea are second in the fucking table. My board want me to win the title. A win over Chelsea would go... Oh, well, the title's already won, but, you know, it's not officially won. The game won't give me the championship until I officially win it. Well, it's in when I officially win it. It still won't fucking give it to me. It'll wait until the end of the season. Still. Oh. Well, I'm going to show you guys the league table before we end up. Because this is complete fucking bullshit. This is complete fucking bullshit. There's no way I can put out a bad team, a second-rate team against Chelsea, even if they have lost 6 games this season. Can I? I mean, I trust my second team. I want my main players to get the glory of winning the cup. That's the whole point of not playing them throughout the cup is to so they act like a fucking thieves in the night when they come in and steal all the glory. At the end of the season. Let's see, there's 13 games remaining. Okay. 13 league games remaining. That was my quick bit of math calculations, you know, that sort of stuff. Calculator, because I can't do math when I'm under pressure or on the spot. I am 26 points ahead of Chelsea. 33 is 39. So the win will put me 29 points ahead with 36. So I only need to win, including the Chelsea game, 4 more games. Oops. I hit the mic and he changed the screen. So I only need to win 4 more games. I'm gonna have to think about this. You'll see my decision in the next episode. Until then, thanks for watching. Hope and enjoy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. Until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.